Good morning, children. Hope you all are fine. Children, from last week we started our revision, isn't it? Today we are going to revise cardinal and ordinal numbers and money. Children, I'll be giving worksheets related to today's topic. Please do that and watch the video again and again and revise all the topics what I am revising. Thank you, children. Children, today let's revise first cardinal and ordinal numbers. As we studied before, what are cardinal numbers? Numbers that are used to count and write. The numbers which are used to count and write, this one pencil, two erasers, okay, 1, 2, 3 like that, okay, 5 pencils, 5 erasers like that. And what are ordinal numbers? Numbers that tells us about the position or an order of something. In a position, like if you are getting what rank you got, what will you tell? I got first rank, I got second rank, I got third rank. So, numbers that tells us the position or an order of something. Which class are you studying? I am studying in third standard, I am studying in first standard, I am studying in second standard. Okay, these are the position or order of something. Okay, for example, I have taken here a flower, cup, a lolly candy, car, toy car, and a star. Now, tell me which is in the third position, in third order. Which is in the third position? This is first position, second position, third position, fourth position, fifth position, isn't it? So, which is in the third position? It is a candy, lollipop, isn't it? So, tell me the one which is in the first position. It is the flower. So, car is in which position? Car is in fourth position. So, that tells us the position or an order of something. So, let's see the cardinal numbers. We know this cardinal numbers already. That is a number used to count and write, isn't it? We used to count and write. 1, 2, 3, T-H-R-E-E, 3, 4, F-O-U-R, 4, 5, F-I-V-E, 5, 6, S-I-X, 6, 7, S-E-V-E-N, 7, 8, E-I-G-H-T, 8, 9, N-I-N-E, 9, and 10, T-E-N, 10. Okay, for ordinal numbers, tells us the position or an order of anything, isn't it, or something else. So, for this, first, F-I-R-S-T, this represented as 1, pakkathil oru S-T, sariya, first. Last two letter of this. Okay. Second. S-E-C-O-N-D. Second. Third. T-H-I-R-D. Third. Fourth. F-O-U-R-T-H. Fourth. Can you see the last two letters? Fifth. F-I-F-T-H. Fifth. S-I-X-T-H, sixth. S-E-V-E-N-T-H, seventh. E-I-G-H-T-H, eighth. Excuse me. N-I-N-T-H, ninth. T-E-N-T-H, tenth. First, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth. Okay, children. Now, let's revise money, the next chapter. Money is in the form of notes and coins. Money is the form of notes and coins. Okay, children, as you know, it is represented by rupees, paise, rupees and paise. Rupees is denoted by this symbol. R-U-P-E-E-S, rupees. Paise is denoted by P. Children, money is in the form of notes and coins. So, it is in the represented by rupees and paise. For rupees is the symbol and for paise it is P. See, the rupees and paise, for example, if I take 55 rupees, 75 paise, the number before this dot, the number before this dot indicates rupees, the number after this dot indicates paise. So, this dot, children, this dot separates rupees and paise. So, the number before this dot is rupees, the after the dot is, it is paise. Children, okay, your mother gave you 10 rupee notes, 10 rupee notes and 1 rupee coins. Some 10 rupee notes and 1 rupee coins. Okay, and ask you to buy 1 notebook and 1 pen. So, you are going to shop now and you are asking for a notebook. So, the shopkeeper tells 1 notebook costs rupees 35. So, how many 10 rupees notes and how many 1 rupee coins you will give? We have discussed this earlier itself in the class. Do you all remember, children? Okay, now see here, in 35, write 1 tens. So, how many tens are there? 3 tens. How many tens are there? 3 tens are there. So, 3 into 10. How many tens are there? 3 tens. In 1's place, it is 5. 5 into 1. 5 ones. So, how many 1 rupee coin? 5 1 rupee coin and 3 10 rupee notes. 30 plus 5, which gives you 35. So, you will give you 3 10 rupee notes and 5 1 rupee coins to make rupees 35. So, you will give 3 10 rupee notes and 5 1 rupee coins to the shopkeeper and you will buy a notebook. Then, your mother asks you to buy pens, isn't it? You are buying 2 pens for rupees 47. Okay, now tell me how many 10 rupee coins and how many 10 rupee notes and how many 1 rupee coin you will give? Easy, no? Tell me, what is the number in the tens place? 4. 4 tens. So, how many 10 rupee coins, 10 rupee notes you will give? 4 tens. 4 into 10. So, 4 10 rupee notes. Okay, children. 4 10 rupee notes. In the ones place, it is 7. 7 ones, isn't it? That is 7 into 1. That is 7 into 1 rupee coin. So, 7 ones are 7. So, 7 1 rupee coin you will give. So, to buy 2 pens, how many 10 rupee notes you will give? You will be giving 4 10 rupee notes and 7 1 rupee coins and you will buy 2 pens for rupees 47. That is 4 into 10. 4 10 rupees na enama, 4 into 10, 40. 7 1 rupee na enama, 7 into 1, that is 7. Add these two, 47, isn't it? So, you will give 4 10 rupee notes and 7 1 rupee coins to buy 2 pens of rupees 47. Understood, children? Now, writing in words and figures. So we are going to write this rupees in words, isn't it? I told you the number before this dot it is rupees and after that it is paise. Okay children, now how many rupees is there? 75 rupees, 30 paise. How much? 75 rupees, 75 rupees, 30 paise. Understood children? And now rupees 98.05. Tell me what to write. 98 rupees. 98 rupees. 5, isn't it? So 5 paise. 5 paise. Now the next one. So how will you write this children? Do you see any number in the rupees place? No, nothing is there. It's 0 only. So only paise part is here. So you have to write 50 paise. 50 paise, paise, because the number is after this dot, isn't it? Inga rupees potrundalo, you have to consider the number where it is placed. It is after this dot, isn't it? After this dot means it is paise. Sariya, so 50 potti, you have to write paise only. Okay, 50 paise. Understood children? Now for example, if I write like this, how will you write? 100 rupees. 100. 100 rupees. Do you find any paise there? Paise edavadhu iruka? Illa. So 100 rupees. Stop with that children. Okay children. Today we revised cardinal and ordinal numbers. And we revised money. Isn't it? I want you all to watch the video thoroughly. Next week we will be giving worksheet for you. I want you all to write. Give your best. See you in the next video with one more chapter to revise children.